The show voicemail is open 24/7. 877-823-8477 is the number to call. You can ask anything you want. We've had people call drunk. We've had people to call say hello, which is great. This is Katie.
Hi, morning show. It's Katie. Me and my daughter love to listen to your show. My man.
It's beautiful. Thank you so much, Katie.
I love that.
Now, here is the one I was excited for today. This is from Holly. Holly's question for the
show. What's up, guys? This is Holly. I'm a huge fan of the show. Always checking out your podcasts. I just love you guys. Get me through the day. My question is, out of all you guys, who has the shortest fuse?
Who has the shortest fuse on the show? Before we give our answers, let me go to Morgan in Mount Airy. Good morning, Morgan.
Morning.
So you know the show fairly well, Morgan. Who on the show do you think has the shortest fuse?
Erick, without a doubt.
And why is that?
It's just so easy to get him riled up. Little things get him going. So
you know, it's very true, Morgan. Thank you for calling. Have a great day.
My man.
Sarah, good morning.
Good morning.
Okay, same question to you. Who do you think on the show has the shortest fuse?
So Erick has the shortest fuse when it comes to defending himself, especially like if he truly believes that he's right. He definitely has the shortest fuse, but I think Riley has the shortest fuse when it comes to if you actually make her angry. I see her being the one where some random stranger tries to reach for her baby, and she's popping off.
Yes. And usually, Sarah, with Riley, I, as any good younger brother does, know exactly what buttons to push.
You sure do. To push them often.
To get that fuse lit. Sarah, thank you for calling. Have a great day.
Thank you. Love you guys.
Bye. All right, Rose, to you. Who do you think has the shortest fuse in the show?
I have to agree with Erick when it comes to defending himself, but Riley's a close second. She's not going to take any crap from anyone. She's going to snap back.
I do think Riley's dealt with a lot of crap in her life in general, so she's extra sensitive to it. But yes, although... Again, I know that, and I can't help myself. I just can't help myself.
You just have to.
My second book will be I Just Can't Help Myself, and it'll be me shrugging my arms. That's gonna be there it is. I would say
the cowboy hat emoji.
Yeah, I would say
for sure, Erick.
Let's go to Renee.
Hey guys, my name's Renee. I've been listening a long time, and
I just
want to know: have you guys ever wanted to change careers?
Okay, Rose, I'll go to you first. Do you ever want to change careers? From Renee.
I don't think I've wanted to change careers. I love my job, but there have been times where I'm I don't know if I can do this anymore and thought about other career possibilities. So one of my backup plans, I always have a backup plan, is to become a dental hygienist.
Oh, awesome.
But I've also recently been interested in bridal salons, because when I got my wedding dress, I was this is the greatest experience ever. I want to make other people this happy. So I was that could also be a backup plan.
That's awesome. For me, I mean, I just like entertaining and making people feel good. So I guess as long as I'm still doing that, then I don't know. I never thought when I started at 17, I think I'd be here. So that's kind of, I don't really put too much thought into it, but if I could it's a weird thing. I would love to coach full time, but then also I think if I was coaching high school hockey full time, it would take away the purity of coaching, if that makes sense. So that's kind of I'm lucky with this job. I can do coaching, which is basically full time, podcast, TV, comedy tour stuff. So it's kind of the mixture of all that. So that's a great question from Renee. Let's go to Francesca.
Hey everyone. My name is Francis. I love the show.
Erick.
And I just want to know, what movie characters inspire you?
Do you want to guess how Erick spelled Francis on the screen for me, Rose? I'll tell you anyway.
F-R-A-N-C-E-S-E.
F-R-A-N-C-E-S-E. Okay, so her question was, what movie character inspires you, Rose?
Ooh. This is a tough one.
Yeah.
I have never thought about this before. I feel like I don't think I have a specific movie character. It's more of a type of person, the type of person that is a little sassy. They stand their ground and they push back when no one else believes in them. That's the type of character that I love.
Besides Christian Grey and Magic Mike, I would say,
Oh Lord.
Okay. Probably Batman. Like, I think I've talked about that before. I've always liked Batman because for the most part, he just wants to like keep to himself, and it's just like he'd rather just be playing with Alfred. But like, if you really need him, he's the first one there.
Yeah, I can see that.
That tends to be me. Like, I'm like, he doesn't go to Gotham when somebody jaywalks, but like when there's actual something going on, he's the first one there. So that's probably for me. These are great questions, by the way.
That makes sense. I can see that. Yeah.
If you want to leave a question, it's 877-823-8477.